Hello everyone, this is Sridhar Iyer and I welcome you once again to my channel and specifically this tutorial series on theory of computer science and automata theory. So let's continue our journey. Let's solve a problem on Turing machines. This kind of a problem is very much complex to understand as it is being asked numerous times in the university exams. So let's focus on this particular problem. We need to construct a Turing machine that accepts a palindrome over the inputs A and B. We have already seen what is a palindrome in our previous videos. In the PDA lectures, I have already shown you how to construct a PDA for palindromes. If you are new to my channel, I would suggest you to kindly go back to my previous videos, especially the pushdown automata section. Have a look at it and the things will be very much clear to you what exactly is a palindrome and how to design logic for such problems. So now get back to this particular problem in hand. As you know, a palindrome is nothing but a word or a string which can be read from both the directions. For example, if I read this particular string from left to right or even from right to left, both of them will have the same meaning. Clear? It can be an odd palindrome or an even palindrome depending upon the length of the inputs of that word. For example, let me take a scenario ABABA. This is an odd palindrome and the previous one was an even palindrome depending upon the length of characters present inside the word or the string. Clear? So let's see how to create the logic for this problem. As you can see, the diagram is quite complex, but it's not that complex if you understand the logic clearly. If you clearly see, we are having two paths. The upper path is for accepting the input B and the lower path is for accepting the input A. Clear? So have a look how we have done so. If the first character encountered is a B, what we'll do, we will select the upper path. Similarly, if the first character encountered is A, we will select the lower path. You can clearly see in Q0 state, if I encounter an A, I will replace that A with a blank and keep moving to the right. So let's take this example only. In this case, if I encounter an A, I will replace that with a B and I will keep moving to the right. Okay. So now while moving to the right, what exactly I'm doing? I will bypass or ignore every other character I encounter till I reach this blank symbol that is present on the extreme right. And once I encounter that blank, I will start moving towards left. So in this example, if I also introduce the blank symbols, it would look like this. Blanks on either end and in between the inputs are present. So what I'm doing, I have replaced the very first A with a blank and started moving to the right. I will bypass every other character that I encounter until I reach the blank symbol. Okay, so what I'm doing, I am keeping the blank as it is, and from that position now I will start moving to the left. Okay, so while coming to the left, the very first A which I encounter, I will replace it with a blank. Why I'm doing so? Because as already explained, I am following the lower path. The lower path is only concerned with the A symbols. So what I am doing, if in the beginning I had encountered an A, so at the end also I would be expecting an A only as the symbol, because we are talking about palindromes. So if I start the word from an A, it should also end with an A. Clear? Similarly, if I start the word with a B, it should also end with a B. So that is what logic I am following in this. If I am starting the transition from an A symbol, I am expecting that that particular word should end with an A symbol only. So what I am doing, I am converting the very first symbol into a blank. I am bypassing every other character that I encounter in between till I reach the end of the symbol, end of the string, and while coming back from the right hand side, the very first string which I encountered, I check whether it's A or not. If it's A, I will come to know that it is a palindrome because it is starting with A and ending with A. Clear? So once I replace that rightmost A with a blank, I will again keep moving to the left, bypassing every other character till the very first blank symbol I encountered. Once I encounter the blank symbol, I will keep it as it is and again restart my transitions while moving to the right. This is how I complete one cycle. Similarly, you can see that now I am left with something like this. Clear? So now what should I do? Now my machine is in state Q0 because it has again refreshed and came back to the initial state. So from this initial state, now the input symbol is B. So what should I do? I should now go to the upper half of the transition diagram, because in Q0, if I encounter a B, I will again do the entire same thing, but this time with respect to the inputs B and not A. So again, the entire thing will be repeated. It will be replaced with a blank. I will go till the extreme right, then come back, replace this B also with a blank, and at the end I would be having something like this, with only one symbol left in the stack, sorry, in the input tape, in state Q0. So again, the machine has refreshed. Now I am in state Q0. If I encounter an A, I will now follow the lower path. I will do the entire same thing, but here there is a stopping condition which we need to take into account. While A is being replaced with a blank this time, we will move to the right. Clear? The machine will move to the right. But what happens over here? Once I have replaced this A with a blank, I have come to the Q4 state. Now I don't have any more inputs of A and B. The next input which I am encountering this time is this blank symbol. Clear? So now from Q4, if I encounter a blank, I will keep the blank as it is and start moving to the left. So that's what I should do from here. I will now start moving to the left. Okay. And while coming back, if I encounter a blank symbol in Q5 state, the machine will come to know that all the inputs have exhausted and now it should move to the final state. So from Q5, if it encounters a blank symbol, it will directly go to the QF state and end the transitions over there by indicating a S symbol or stop symbol over there, signal over there. Clear? This was an example of an odd palindrome. But in case we are having an even palindrome, what will happen? This A will be replaced with a blank. This A will be replaced with a blank. So after one cycle, we will be left with two B's. This will be replaced with a blank. This will be replaced with a blank. So now in Q0 state, after two cycles, the very next input, which is pointed by the read-write head, would be a blank symbol. So in the case of an even palindrome, if we encounter a blank in the Q0 state, then we can move to the QF state directly using the transition. So I think this example is clear to you. That is, if we are talking about odd palindromes, if the input symbol is B, then a transition from Q2 will be made to the final state, and if the input was A, then a transition from Q5 will be made to the final state by accepting all the inputs. Clear? So this is how we construct a palindrome using Turing machines. This is a general case where we are dealing with both even as well as odd palindromes. So let's have a look at the example. I've already shown you how to solve it, but let's see the step-by-step simulation of how exactly palindromes are simulated using Turing machines. This is the case of an even palindrome. I have taken the same example. The first input symbol is A in Q0 state. I replaced that with a blank and kept moving to the right. So according to our diagram, in Q4 state, if I encounter a B, I will bypass it, okay, and move to the right. So that is what we have done. In Q4, the machine will remain in Q4, but the pointer has moved to the right, to the next symbol. This will keep on continuing till this particular value. So in Q4, if I encounter a blank, what should I do? I will replace the blank with blank only and start moving to the left, as I had explained earlier. So while coming back to the left, according to my logic, what should I do? The very first input symbol was A, so we should replace the very last input symbol A also with a blank. So that's what we have done. In Q5, if we encounter an A, we directly go to Q3 by replacing it by a blank. So that is what we have done. So we have completed one cycle. The next cycle again will be repeated like this. From Q0, we'll encounter a B this time. So we'll jump to the upper half of the transition diagram and solve the problem in likewise. And at the end, we will be left with this particular scenario where we'll be having all the blanks and the machine will jump to the QF state or the final state. Similarly, we can also solve it for a odd palindrome. I have already shown you what is an odd palindrome. So in Q0, we are starting with B this time. So we'll take the upper half. At the end of the first cycle, we'll come back over here. So the same logic has been used, the same transition functions have been used. Only difference lies over here, where we are left with only one symbol Q in the Q3 state. So you can see that after two cycles, the machine comes back to the Q0 state, and this time it is pointing to input B. So again, it will take the upper half, and now this time we'll be having all the blank symbols. So as per our logic, if the input symbol left is B, so a transition from the Q2 state, you can check over here. So a transition from the Q2 state will be made to the QF state, because we have read the last input as a B. If the last input would have been an A, the transition would have been made from the Q5 state to the QF state. And this is how we construct a Turing machine for solving problems based on palindromes. I hope it was clear to you. The last step remaining is the transition table. You can simply check the diagram on the top right and start filling up the transition table. Transition table is nothing but you need to check from which state on which input the machine goes into which particular state. So for example, in Q0, if the input is A, the machine goes to Q4 state, it replaces the A with a blank and makes a transition to the right. So this is how we solve problems based on Turing machines for solving palindromes. So I hope this was clear to you. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for further more problems on Turing machines. In the upcoming videos, we are going to see how to solve Turing machines for such problems where WCWR is nothing but a palindrome only, but we will be having some character C in between. Also, we can solve problems based on WCW. That is, it would be something like this. It is not a palindrome. It is simply the same string repeated once again and a C character in between. So we'll see these problems in the upcoming video. So stay tuned and thanks for subscribing to my channel. If you have not yet subscribed, kindly press the bell icon and subscribe to my channel to stay in touch with more such upcoming videos in the future. Thank you so much.